This video is going to be about factoring a polynomial, and we're going to do this by factoring out the greatest common factor. So let's see what this means. Here we've got a multiplication problem. I'm multiplying this monomial, 5x squared, times the binomial, 2x minus 3. So basically, I'm just distributing this 5x squared across the binomial. So I've got 5 times 2 is 10. X squared times x is x to the third. And then 5 times negative 3 is negative 15. And since there's no x over here, I just have the x squared. And I get this result. Now, if I had done this backwards and started with this and tried to get to here, I would be factoring this. In other words, when you factor something, you're looking for two things that you can multiply together. They may be just numbers, they may be polynomials. You're looking for two things you can multiply together that will give you this solution. So in other words, I want to figure out how did we get here. The numbers that make this up are called the factors of this polynomial, or the polynomials that make it up are called the factors of the polynomial. So let's see how we got here. Let's start with 10x to the third minus 15x squared. Now, what I'm looking for, when I'm looking for the factors, is going to be some monomial over here and a polynomial that I can fit in these parentheses. Remember, I'm working backwards trying to get to here as if I don't know what this is. So I've got a 10 and a negative 15, and I know that I can divide them both by 5. I'm going to put a 5 over here, and 5 into 10 goes 2 times. And so that tells me that when I multiplied, in other words, if I started here and wanted to get back to here, 5 times 2 is going to give me the 10. And 5 into negative 15 is negative 3. Negative 3 times 5 is negative 15. Now, when you get to the variables, it's really simple. All you do is look at your variables. I've got two x's. Then look at the exponents. Choose the smallest exponent, and that's going to be what you can factor out. In other words, I'm factoring out an x squared. And then figuring out what's left, I take this x to the third, divide it by x squared, and I get an x. I take this x squared, divide it by x squared, I get a 1. I don't have to write a 1 here since negative 3 times 1 is still going to be negative 3. And this will be my factorization of this polynomial. If you want to check to make sure your work is correct, take your factorization and multiply it out. So 5x squared times 2x is 10x to the third. X squared times negative 3, 5x squared times negative 3 is negative 15x squared, and that's where I started. If you get back to where you started, then your work is correct. Let's look at another one. After you've done enough of these, they just become kind of automatic. I've got 6 a to the third b squared plus 9 a squared b, and I want to find out what monomial, which I'm going to put here, was multiplied by what polynomial, which is going to go in the parentheses. So looking at the coefficients first, I've got a 6 and a 9, and I realize that both of them came about by being multiplied by 3. So I'm going to factor out a 3. Factoring a 3 out of the 6 is going to leave me with a 2, and factoring a 3 out of 9 will leave me with a positive 3. Then I go out to my variables. I've got a's and b's. Let's start with the a's. A to the third and a squared. Well, 2 is my smallest exponent, so I'm going to factor out an a squared. Factoring a squared out of a to the third means I'm just dividing a to the third by a squared. So I'm subtracting this 2 from this 3, and I just get an a over here. Dividing a squared by a squared, I just get a squared. I'm sorry, I just get a 1, which I don't have to write because 3 times 1 is still going to be 3. I've now got a b squared and a b. Remember, anytime you don't see an exponent, you can put a 1 in just to remind you that the exponent is 1. So the smallest exponent I have is 1. That means I'm going to factor out a b. I'm sorry, I jumped ahead. Factoring the b out of the b squared is going to give me a b. Factoring b out of b is going to give me a 1. So once again, I don't need that 1. I might as well move this parentheses a little closer. And this is going to be my answer. Multiplying this back to make sure I'm right, 3 times 2 is 6. A squared times a is a to the third. B times b is b squared. 3 times 3 is 9. And then I've got an a squared and a b. And that's right where I started. Okay, so this works. Here's one more. In this case, I've got a trinomial. I've got 3 terms. This is no harder, just a little more work involved in it. Okay, so I'm looking for a monomial and then a trinomial that I'll put inside parentheses. So the first thing I see is everything is negative. So I'm going to factor out some negative factor. Looking at the 4 and the 8, I realize I could divide them both by 4, but I've got to be careful because I can't divide the 10 by a 4. So that means 4 is not going to be the greatest common factor for all of them. So looking again, I realize they're all even, so I know I can factor out a 2. Taking this negative 4 and dividing it by negative 2 is going to leave me with a 2 here. The negative 8 divided by negative 2 will leave me with a positive 4. Negative 10 divided by negative 2 will leave me with a positive 5. Going on to the variables, I've got x to the fourth, x to the third, and x squared. 2 is my smallest exponent, so I'm factoring out x squared. X to the fourth divided by x squared will leave me with an x squared over here. X to the third divided by x squared will leave me with an x. And x squared divided by x squared will leave me with just a 1. Going on to the y's, I've got a 2, a 3, and a 5 as my exponents. So my smallest exponent is 2. So I'm going to factor out a y squared. Y squared divided by y squared is just a 1, so I don't have to write that there. Y to the third times y squared, y to the third divided by y squared is just y, so I'll put a y in here. And y to the fifth divided by y squared will give me a y to the third. So this is going to be my factorization. And again, to check this, we would just multiply it out and make sure we got back to where we started. Okay, so the basic process is this. You're looking at your polynomial, and what you want to do is break it down into a monomial, which is going to be the greatest common factor of this polynomial. And then you want to find out what numbers, what polynomial you have left that that monomial multiplies. So you start with your constants. See what the biggest number is you can divide into each of the constants. That's going to come out as the coefficient of your monomial. You're going to, whatever that is, in this case negative 2, you'll divide that into each of the coefficients that you started with, and that will give you the coefficients of your polynomial in your answer. Then you're going to look at the exponents for each of the variables. You'll take the smallest exponent, and that will let you know what the variable is in your monomial. And then you'll factor that out of each of the exponents that you started with and use those in the polynomial that's your answer. Okay, so this is not that hard. It's just a matter of practicing enough of them so they become routine. Okay, take care.